Dragicevic. I don't want to say too much about him, that is why we listen to him, because he speaks with his life. We'll begin with prayer. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. Blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Koji sada I vas vijeke vijekova.
Queen of peace and reconciliation, pray for us in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Hvaljen Isus I Mar.
Praise be Jesus and Mary.
Dragi prijatelji.
Dear friends.
Dragi mladi.
Dear youth.
Dragi svećenici.
Dear priests.
Prijatelji u Kristu.
Friends in Christ, at the beginning of this meeting, together with all of you, I desire to greet all of you with my heart. It is a joy for me today to be with you and to share with you that what is the most important, and the most important messages to which the Mother has been calling us through these 33 years.
33 godine milosti.
33 years of grace.
Došli smo ovdje.
We have come here.
Umorni.
Tired.
Umorni od ovoga
svijeta. Tired of this world. Of the tempo of life that today's world has imposed upon us. Especially to all of us, the young. We have come here. To be spiritually renewed, strengthened, to be spiritually renewed, and to again set out on the way, again to set out on the way, to follow the Lord, to put Him in the first place, and to walk. We have come here to the spring, the source, because Jesus says, come to me, all of you who are burdened and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. I will give you the strength. And truly we have come to the source, the spring. We have come to the Mother to surrender to her our needs, our desires, our families, our problems, our difficulties that we face every day. We've come to her to say to her, Mother, pray for us. Intercede before your Son for all of us. Yes, the Mother prays for all of us. She carries us in her heart. She's placed us into her heart. That is why we are never alone. She is with us. She accompanies us on the way. Our Lady says, at the beginning of the very apparitions, she said, I am the Queen of Peace. I come, dear children, because my Son is sending me to help you. Dear children, peace, only peace. May peace begin to reign in the world. Dear children, peace must reign between God and man and among men. Dear children, this world and humanity is in very great danger and is threatening to destroy itself. These were the first words, the first messages that Our Lady has spoken to us and transmitted to us. She comes to us from the King of Peace. Our Son sends her that she may lead us towards peace, towards her Son. And Jesus is our only true peace. Our Lady through these years has not said anything new. We know everything from the sacred scripture, from the tradition of the church. So when we hear about peace, conversion, fasting, love, forgiveness, then we recognize the sacred scripture. When we hear to pray the rosary, to go to Holy Mass, to confess, to read the sacred scripture, to adore Jesus, then we recognize the tradition of the church. Why is that people oftentimes ask, why does Our Lady speak so much? She is speaking so much, repeating so much, and is not saying anything new to us. You see, every mother must repeat. There is no mother today that once has said something to a child and didn't have to repeat it ever again. Every mother must repeat. So, it is with Our Lady, with us for the 33 years. Our Lady is repeating that we may not forget. Today I would not like to have you see me as somebody perfect or as a saint here, because I'm not. I strive to be better, to be holier. This is my desire. The desire is profoundly impressed in my heart. It doesn't mean that because I saw Our Lady that overnight I have converted and changed. I know that my conversion, as the conversion of each one of us, is a process, a program for our life, for which we must decide to be persevering, to change every day, to every day leave behind sin and evil, to open ourselves to peace, to open ourselves to the Holy Spirit, to be open to the grace, to accept Christ's word, to live it in our lives, and so to grow in holiness. But through these 33 years, every day, anew, a question is asked. A question that arises in me. Mother, why me? Mother, weren't there others who were better than me? Mother, will I be able to fulfill everything that you're asking of me, to carry it out in the way that you ask and desire? There isn't a single day that that question is not posed inside of me. I remember very well at one apparition when I was alone with her. I held back, I hesitated, I didn't know what she would say to me. But that day I decided to ask her, and I asked her. I asked, Mother, why me in particular? Why did you choose me in particular? The lady sweetly smiled and said, Dear child, you know, I don't always seek the best.
Prije 33 godine Gospa je izabrala mene.
33 years ago, a lady chose me. She inscribed me in her school, the school of peace, school of love, school of prayer,
biti dobar đak.
In this school I desire to be a good student.
And
every day I desire to fulfill all the better the homework that I get from a lady. But I always ask myself, Mother, why are you not appearing to everyone? Mother, everyone would believe you. I certainly would not be here with you today. I wouldn't have to speak to you. If she did this, well, we certainly could have entered all of God's plans. But He plans with each one of us and desires of each one of us. But we must be open to these plans of God. We must know how to recognize them and accept them, not to reject them.
And
even though we do not see her, we must be happy that she's with us. In the Gospel it is said, blessed are those who do not see and believe. For me, for my life, and for my family, this is certainly a great, great gift, but certainly also a great responsibility. And I live with this responsibility every day, in the morning when I get up, in the evening when I lie down. I carry that responsibility. I carry that gift that I have. But believe me, it is not easy and it's not simple to be with Our Lady every day, to speak with her every day, 5 minutes or 10, sometimes even more. And then after every meeting with her, to again to return to earth and to live on this earth. Because to be with Our Lady every day means to be with her in heaven. It means to look at heaven. If you saw Our Lady even for a second, just 1 second, no more. I don't know if your life on earth would be interesting anymore to you, even after 1 second. Every day after a meeting with her, I need several hours to come back from this meeting into this world. What is it that is the most important? And what are these most important messages to which the Mother is calling us through these years? You yourselves know that Our Lady gave all of us very many messages. But if we were to pause at the key, most important messages, I would like to then separate these messages. Peace, conversion, return to God, pray with the heart, penance and fasting, firm faith, love, forgiveness, the Eucharist, reading of the Sacred Scripture, confession, and the message of hope. You see, these messages that I have in a special way separated and accentuated, these are the most important messages through which He's been leading us in these years. Each one of these messages, Our Lady, makes simple that we may understand it better and live it better. The Mother comes to us as the Queen of Peace. And who can better know than a mother? How much this tired world is in need. These tired families, this tired youth are in need, this tired church. She comes to us as the mother of the church. And she says, dear children, if you will be strong, then the church will also be strong. If you are to be weak, then the church will be weak. You are my living church. Dear youth, gathered today here, you are the living church. You are the lungs of the church.
Zato se Gospa raduje kroz ove dane ovde zajedno s vama.
That's why our Lady rejoices during these days with you. She blesses you every day with her blessing of peace and love. You are not alone. She carries us. She is with us. In a special way, Our Lady calls us to renew family prayer, to put God in the first place in our families, and to set out with Him into the future. Then we will be sure. Then we will be protected. Then we will have peace. That peace of Christ. Our Lady is calling us. She is not tired of calling us. Our Lady, one of the messages said, Dear children, you are the living church. There is no living church without living families. Today's family is spiritually sick. These are Lady's words. She is saying this. She is the one who gives the diagnosis to us today. Today's family is bleeding, and the mother is calling us. She desires to bind our wounds, to heal our wounds with so much love, tenderness, and with mother's warmth. Today's families need to be spiritually healed. Without the healing in the family, this sick society and community in the world cannot be healed. It was important for the family to be healed. And today, you, the youth who are here, you're here to pray for that intention in a special way for family, for the holiness of the family. Our Lady is calling us to decide for Jesus, to set out with Him. In one of the messages she says, Dear children, today's world is in a great crisis, and the greatest crisis is a crisis of faith in God. That is why it is because we are distanced from prayer, from God. She says, Dear children, today's world has set out in a future with our God. Dear children, today's world cannot give you peace. That peace the world gives you, you will be quickly disappointed in that peace. Peace is only in God. That is why be open to the gift of peace. Pray for the gift of peace, for your good. Renew prayer. Prayer has disappeared in your families. Parents no longer pray with their children. Children do not pray with their parents. In families, there's a lack of time for each other. There are so many tired and broken families. There is the breakup of morals, the influence of media and television. The modern world of technology more and more is pressing on today's youth and families. And another person really calls us, return to God, put Him in the first place. Start to pray, return prayer in your families. The mother tirelessly calls us. Today's world is not, as many say in media and newspapers, in some kind of economic recession or crisis. Today's world, today's society is in spiritual crisis. And every spiritual crisis also causes and generates every other crisis in a family and elsewhere. The mother comes to us. She comes to us because she desires to encourage us. She desires to console us. She did not come to us to bring fear to us, to punish us, to criticize us, to speak to us about the end of the world. about the second coming of Jesus. No. She's coming as a mother of hope. She desires to bring hope today into this world, this tired world that has been left without hope. In a special way, Our Lady through these years especially is calling us to the Holy Mass, that we may place the Holy Mass in the first place in our lives, as the center of our lives. In one of the apparitions, kneeling before Our Lady, all six of us, Our Lady said to us, she said, "Dear children, if today you decide to come to me, to meet me, or to go to Holy Mass, no, do not come to me. Go to Holy Mass." Because to go to Holy Mass means to go to Jesus who gives himself to you in the Eucharist. To open ourselves to Him, to surrender to Him, to accept Him. Our Lady likewise calls us to monthly confession, to veneration of Jesus on the cross, adoration before the Blessed Sacrament. Our Lady calls us also to prayer of the Rosary in our families. In a special way, she calls us to the reading of the Sacred Scripture in our families. In one of the messages she said, "Dear children, may the Bible be in a visible place in each of your families. Read the Sacred Scripture. That by reading the Sacred Scripture, Jesus may again be born in your hearts, in your families. May this be a spiritual food on your life's journey. Forgive, dear children. Forgive others. Love others. We especially like to stress the call to forgiveness. Olivia has been calling us so often to forgiveness through these years. To forgive ourselves. To forgive others. And thus to open the way to the Holy Spirit to come to our hearts. Because without forgiveness, we cannot be healed, not spiritually, not physically, nor emotionally. We must forgive. But for our forgiveness to be holy and perfect, complete, He calls us in a special way to pray with the heart. So often she has repeated the words, "Pray, pray, pray, dear children. Do not grow tired of prayer. Be persevering in prayer. Do not pray with your lips. Do not pray mechanically out of tradition, but pray with the heart. But to pray, look at our watch, seeing how quickly can we finish. Our Lady calls us to pray with the heart. To decide for God. To set apart time for God. To pray with the heart to which the Mother calls us is first of all, it means to pray out of love. And with love, to pray with one's entire being, that our prayer that we're praying truly may become a meeting with Jesus, a conversation with Jesus, a rest together with Him. That from the prayer with the heart, we may be coming out filled with peace and joy. Our Lady says, "Dear children, may prayer be joy for you. Rejoice in prayer. Dear children, who prays does not have to be afraid of the future. She knows that we are not perfect. She knows that it's very difficult for us to be recollected in prayer, to concentrate in prayer, but Our Lady desires. She desires for us to decide for prayer and to go and set out in the school of prayer, that every day we may learn and thus grow. But it is a desire is for us to pray 3 hours every day. That is her desire. This is an ultimatum. That is the desire of the mother. My lady asks for 3 hours of prayer. She does not ask for us to pray only the rosary, or that we pray 3 hours all at once. My lady asks for 3 hours of the prayer. My lady is considering and desires that there be Holy Mass, reading of the Sacred Scripture, prayer of the Rosary, doing good, helping others, to adore Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament, to speak in our families. That is what Our Lady desires from us. That is what she recommends to us. I always remember a pilgrim who 7 years ago came here to us to Medjugorje. She came to me and said to me, Ivan, I can't understand at all how Our Lady can ask for 3 hours of prayer. That can't be Our Lady. We sat down and spoke. I tried to explain to her, and it was of no use. She went back home. A year later, the same pilgrim came to me again, and again she asked me, Ivan, is Our Lady still asking for 3 hours of prayer? And I said, Our Lady is not asking for 3 hours anymore. She's asking for 24 hours. You know what that pilgrim said? Okay, then I'll stay with three. You see how sometimes we're so selfish in prayer.
Our
Lady is not asking of us that what we cannot accept. She is giving to us what we can accept. One of my friends, who is always a little skeptical, whenever Our Lady gives a message every 25th of the month, he meets me the day after and says, I know the message Our Lady gave yesterday. It's again, pray. I asked him, but friend, did you start to pray? He wasn't sure of himself. And I said, dear friend, there you go. That's what Our Lady is repeating again. How did you start to pray? Then Our Lady Yesu would not have to repeat the same thing. She would have said something new. That applies to all of us. We must accept, live, that to what Our Lady is calling us to set out in the school of prayer. Because Our Lady said, dear children, if you desire to go into the school of prayer, then you must go to the school of prayer. There are no weekends. There is no rest. Every day we must go into the school of prayer as individuals, as families, as a community. And Our Lady says, dear children, if you desire to pray better, we must always pray more, because to pray more is always a personal decision, but to pray better is grace, a grace that is given to those who pray more. Oftentimes we know how to say that we don't have time to pray, but we are working a lot, we are occupied with these or those things. The children are going to school, we can't gather the family together. And always we need to pray, to be together in prayer. There's always the problem of time. But Ali says very simply to each one of us, she says, dear children, don't always say that you don't have time. Time is not the problem. Dear children, the problem is love. Because dear children, if a person loves something, he always has time for it. But a person does not like or love something, he will never find the time for it. Here, dear friends, dear youth, you see how love moves. If there is love, everything is possible. Lady comes to us here during these years. She desires to really wake us up through the spiritual coma in which the world is, to awaken us from this spiritual death and dying, and to firm us in faith and love. Also today, in a special way, I recommend all of you, of your needs, your families, everything you have brought to the mother, and the mother knows her heart, and she prays, she will pray for all of us. And I hope that we will respond to her call and to accept her messages and to be the co-creator of a new and better world, a world worthy of the children of God, as well as also be apostles, new apostles, because we are called to that by the Mother. An apostle can be only the one who lives the message in order to be able to carry it and give it to others. Let us also be the new seed of the new world. And I hope that you here, through these days, you will sow the good seed, that this seed that you will sow will fall on the good soil and bear good fruit. This time in which we live is a time of responsibility. This is why truly, let us responsibly accept the message to which the Mother is calling us. For this time, let us especially pray for the evangelization of the world and the families. Let us pray for the Holy Father, that he may continue the way, and continue the work that he has begun. And he needs our prayers. I know that a lady prays for him, but we also pray together with him. Let us also today be a living sign, a sign of the living faith. Let us not look for outside, external signs to see something or touch something that we may be convinced. Oh yes, now I believe. As I said, Our Lady is asking of us today that we may be the living sign, the sign of the living faith. Dear friends, dear youth, Jesus so often in the Gospel repeats, do not be afraid. Our Lady has repeated these words also to us many times. Do not be afraid, dear children. As well as also decide here. Let's decide for God to set out together with him. May it be so. Thank you so much. May the Lord accompany you on your way. And my Lady protect you. Queen of Peace, pray for us.
Što reći nego hvala.
Can we say other than thank you to Ivan who touched your heart? Leading us to the heart of Mary. Bringing to us a clear sign and the way of what we're to do. Ivan, thank you. Now we have a choir.